Good morning, there is dirt on you, there we go, and welcome to weekly vlog 26. I'm about to pop out to Pets at Home because I need to get some bedding for the hamster and some food, and to Tesco's because, let me get my phone, first I need to get a new foundation, so, and I don't want to spend a lot of money on one, so I'm going to Tesco's and I'm just going to get like a super, a drugstore one, and because I want to get a like wash in wash out or like semi-permanent hair dye for this colour. It's like a rose goldy pink. I really want to try that colour. Like my friend dyed her hair a rose gold pink and then I saw her the other day and it looked so nice. I know my hair's like probably a bit darker than hers, that's why I picked that colour, because her colour was a lot pinker. But I really want to see what I think and whether it suits me, so I'm going to get a semi-permanent one just so I can see kind of what it would look like, and if I like it, I've already sent a picture to my hairdresser and been like, do you think my hair would actually go this colour? And she thinks it would, but it'll take a couple of stages, so that's why I want to try with the semi-permanent first, to see if I actually like it and if it's worth me like trying to do it. That's what I'm gonna do. Yeah, and then I'm gonna come home and I wanna bake a cake because I still haven't baked a cake that I wanna bake. I need to film a video, if not two. I'd quite like to film two, but I feel like only one is gonna happen. Then I'm gonna dye my hair and I'm gonna show you what it looks like, and I want your opinions as well when it's done. But first, we must go to Pets at Home, and I've just realized I still have a Christmas stocking. Should probably put that one away. My fairy lights are still up though. I think they look really cute. And you can't tell they're snowflakes, so why not keep them up? Quite like filming sitting here. Might film more videos sat here. I'm literally just sat in my stall with my little coolie doodah thing. So it sits on the mirror. But I thought I would show you. Okay, this is the hair dye that I've got. It is permanent. So I'm really nervous that I'm not gonna like it, but this is the one that Lucy had in her house, which is the one that I was like staring at. Sorry, Lucy, if you're watching, I do stalk what beauty things you have. But it says it will go this kind of colour. There we go. So this kind of colour, which I really like, and it is more the sort of colour that I want to go. But what if I don't like it? It's permanent. Like, if I don't like this colour, I'm gonna have to like strip wash my hair, like with Head and Shoulders or something. I'm really nervous. I think it would suit me. It'll make me look really pale. I might just be like, whatever, go for it. And if I don't like it, I don't like it. And I'll just live with it. It'll grow out, won't it? And it'll wash out eventually. And the foundation I went for is this one. The Rimmel Wake Me Up. They didn't really have much option in Tesco's. And I really couldn't bother to go like all the way into town to go into Boots and stuff. But I've heard really good things about this one. And it's a brightening one, which I really need at this time of year. I was using, it was still a Rimmel one I was using. I think it... Let me find it in my makeup bag. It was this one that I was using. Focus! Oh, I'll just tell you, it was the Lasting Finish by Rimmel. That's what I have been using. It has just run out. And to be fair, by the end of it, I wasn't really enjoying it. But I don't know if it's because it was just old. Like, I had been using it probably, like, over a month. I just feel like the end of the bottle just kind of didn't give the same results that it used to when I first got it. But apart from that, I did still really like this foundation, but I wanted to try a different one just because I wasn't really enjoying it now. So I'm trying the Wake Me Up one. I also picked like a little shopping haul, isn't it? Ice and Sugar and some like Hundreds and Thousands sprinkles. There you go. Now, did any of you, when you were in school or primary school or whatever, used to have the cake, if you got school dinners, that was like a vanilla sponge and it had water icing over the top and Hundreds of Thousands, and you used to have it with warm custard? That is what I have been craving the last few days, so that is what I'm going to make. I'm going to use a packet mix because I can't bother to do a normal cake, but I'm using the Betty Crocker, like, vanilla one because I'm lazy. But yeah, I'm really excited. I'm going to cut it into, like, squares and everything. Like little cubes, and put Hundreds of Thousands on top. Okay, light's difference. I've just set up my camera to do a main video, but I've just spoken to Chris about my hair, and he was like, go for it. And I know it sounds really stupid, but kind of having... Chris is quite opinionated, and like if he doesn't like something, he will say. But he was like, go for it, I think it will suit you. So, I'm a bit more confident about it now. I'm just going to say it for you. My hair is orange. Literally. Oh well, looks like I'm just gonna have to be using Head and Shoulders for the next okay, I'm just gonna point it out there, it looks way more orange on this camera than it does in real life. But I'm just gonna have to use some Head and Shoulders and strip it out. But yeah, there is no hint of pink in this hair. So glad I have a week off work right now. You can't laugh at yourself, who can you laugh at? Good morning. Well, it's not morning at all. It is 4:15 because I've been in bed most of the day feeling pretty sorry for myself. I woke up feeling really ill, like really feverish. I was so hot. I had such a temperature and I was gutted because I was meant to go with Chris today to go and pick up his new car, but he's had to take a friend with him instead. So yeah, I've pretty much been asleep most of the day or just like chilling in bed with the cat. But now I'm going back to Tesco's to get some more hair dye because I obviously can't live my life with ginger hair. Well, I can. So many people have said they like it. Like, everyone that I've shown has been like, oh, I actually quite like it. It's quite nice. I'm like, mm-hmm. It's not on your head though, is it? So I'm gonna go buy some dye. I wanted to get a color that was like more similar to my normal hair color, but I'm a bit nervous because I feel like I'm really worried that my hair's gonna go green. Because last time I dyed my hair from like a light colour to my natural colour, it went green. But that was because, I feel like that was because it was bleached. I don't think this isn't bleach, so technically we should be okay, right? But yeah, if it goes green, I may be calling a hair salon for an emergency hair appointment on like when Friday morning or something. Be like, fix my hair, please! And I should have listened to my own advice. I swore last time I dyed my hair and when it went green last time that I would never do a home dye kit again. And I did it, and I'm orange. To be fair, it doesn't look that bad in this camera, but yeah. I'm just not feeling it right now, so I'm gonna go Tesco's and buy some more hair dye. I'm really glad it's hat weather as well, otherwise, bright head.
Right, I picked up two colours. I got this one, which is natural dark ash blonde, which is probably closest to my natural colour. And I got a darker brown as well. They were on like 2 for £6 and they're £5 when they were in, so I was like, for a quid, I might as well get another one. Just in case this one doesn't work. Yeah. I don't know, I have a really weird feeling it's gonna go green. Why did I do this? Oh well, you live and you learn. But I think I'm gonna try this one first.
Looks so weird. I'm just testing out like a little bit of my hair to see what color it goes, just in case it does go green. But I'm trying this one first, the lighter one. But I didn't wanna like put it all over my head and then it go green. So I'm just testing this little bit, see what it does. I've just put it on, so I'm just gonna watch it. Just watch it. Okay, I'm happy with my hair. It's still a bit gingery, but I actually really, really like this color. Like, this is a strawberry blonde. I can cope with this. There is still like tiny hints of pink in places, but not in a lot of places. I've saved it. I feel like me again. Thank goodness. Because I was absolutely terrified the whole time I was dying that. I was like, oh my goodness, it's gonna go green. It's gonna look awful. But I am me again. Good morning. You may notice my hair is still ginger. Yes, the dye didn't take quite as well as I thought. However, I actually quite like this colour, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I quite like it. So I'm just gonna embrace it for a few days and then maybe use the darker brown on Sunday, because I've obviously used two hair dyes in the space of 24 hours, which is not good. So I'm gonna give it a little rest, see how I feel about it, see what everyone else says, and maybe use the darker one on it on Sunday before I go back to work on Monday. So I'm not sure how I feel about working with my hair like this, but I'm embracing it, and I've matched my eyeshadow to my hair, and well, sometimes you just gotta make the most of some mistakes and go with it, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm about to leave to go to Daniel's, so we'll see what he thinks. I'll ask him on camera what he thinks of my hair, shall I? I'll do that, see what he says. So yeah, I think that's where I'm gonna get the most honest feedback, is when I go see Daniel, because all of his work colleagues and things will probably say things, but yeah, we'll just go from there. But look at this. Chris picked his car up yesterday. So when you look out your window and the first thing you see is two Mercedes and your brother owns both of them. Yeah. Not something I ever thought I would ever say. But he should be very proud of himself because he's worked really hard. for what he has now. So, I know, soppy moment, sorry. But yes, I need to go. It's 20 to 1. And let's go get bullied for my hair, shall we? That's an exaggeration. Look, though. To be fair, I'm just happy that it isn't as, like, bright as it was yesterday.
Good evening. I didn't vlog anything else yesterday, obviously, and I'm probably not going to vlog anything else today. As you can tell, it's dark outside and it's 10 to 6 and I'm about to drive to London to go and see my little pipsqueak. I'm staying at Hare's tonight. We're having a girly sleepover, so I don't know if I'm going to vlog anything else tonight or not. If I do, you'll see. If I don't, you'll see me tomorrow. But I thought I would just at least say hi today. Myself and Daniel had a really lazy day. His heating's broken, so we just spent the day on the sofa with the duvet. And we started watching A Series of Unfortunate Events. It's really good, actually. Very bizarre, but very similar. It's basically the film, really long-winded, but it's really good. I recommend it. And now I'm driving to see Pippa in London. It should take me about an hour and a bit, or I should get there about 7, so it shouldn't be too bad. I'm hoping by the time I hit London I'll have missed some of, like, a lot of the traffic, so it should be okay. So I will either see you later or I will see you tomorrow. I think we're going to Portobello Market tomorrow, and I'm really excited because I've never been and it's somewhere I've always wanted to go, so that should be exciting. But yeah, I need to go, so I will see you later or see you.
I'd say good morning, but I would be lying because it's actually 2 p.m. We have spent the morning, like, in bed doing blogger things, Instagram, and doing lots of planning but not much activity. So we are getting ready and we're going to go to Portobello Market, which I'm so excited for. I've never been. It's somewhere I've always wanted to go ever since watching Bedknobs and Broomsticks. It is somewhere I've wanted to go, so I'm very, very excited. This is what I'm wearing.
My room is such a mess, though.
The bed is, yeah. That is what happens when you get two bloggers in the same room.
Yeah.
I have got on my Zara top, which is a ridiculously soft one, and then Pippa. I've always wanted to go with the choker, but I've always been really scared because I think I have a really short neck, but Pippa's assured me that it looks good, so I'm just going to go with it.
Mm-hmm.
Go with it. And I've got my, these jeans, what are they? I think my Topshop Jamie jeans, but the non-holy ones, because it's cold. And then a belt, again, this is Pippa's, this is your mum's?
Vintage.
Yes, vintage. And it's so nice. And then while I'm at Portobello Market, I want to get a ring for this finger. Focus on my hand, thank you. I really want one like the Monica Veranda ones, like the open ones. I tweeted a picture of it being like, please someone find me a cheaper version because it's £160 and I'm not spending £160 on a ring that is not going to be worn forever, if you know what I mean. So I want a cheaper version, or like a really nice vintagey ring, one that will go with my grandma's ring as well. So that is my challenge for today, is to find a ring there. I'm so breathless today. I'm like,
we've done nothing all day.
Yeah. But we need to get a move on because the light's going to go. We want to take we want to take some pictures and stuff. So please. Also, I need to show you Pippa's fireplace because it's literally life goals. Let's go on a little tour of her house. Down the stairs. Seriously, look at this fireplace. Oh, it's amazing. With the fairy lights around it as well. Hello. I love it. Literally obsessed with her house. The last time I came to Pippa's, they've just started like renovating the house and stuff. Now it looks incredible. I love it. But yes, I will probably catch up with you once we are on the move. Oh, it's so busy.
They'll get off the track.
Yeah, they'll get off the track.
We finally arrived. Yay! I tried to get a picture of it, but I'm too small and it just looks really random. But we've already been into Starbucks to get tea because it's so cold.
It is so chilly.
So chilly.
But we are on our way. And the sun hasn't gone down yet.
Yay!
Oh, I'm spilling it.
I got it. I need to actually drink some of it because I haven't drunk any of it yet. Oh, I love it.
Pretty.
I love London. I look so cold, like my nose is rosy red. I think I found my favourite street. Look at this.
Goals.
Seriously.
I need a bin.
She needs a bin. What road is this? Kensington Park Gardens. Yeah. And I am in love.
Oh my god, look at that lampshade in this house.
Okay, is coming. Nice? We're going to look at a lampshade in a house. Yes. Look at that lampshade. This is literally life goals. This is Laurel, by the way. I'll leave all her like social media links down below as well. She's so lovely. Oh, thanks, babe. She bought my tea.
Right.
Completely forgotted about it.
Okay,
people, if I ever came to live in London, this is exactly where I would want to live. But it's also like the most unrealistic place ever to come and try and live. Oh, Laurel's found a grey door.
Grey door.
I tell you what, spending a day with vloggers is so much nicer than trying to vlog with people that don't get it.
We totally get it.
Yeah,
you can. Cameras at the ready.
You can just randomly start talking to yourself and no one's like, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
In the background. My camera died so annoyingly while we were out, but the wonderful Pippa here has filmed a couple of things which you will have seen already, because I'm gonna do like a little montage-y thing, I think.
Yeah,
of our day out. But I just wanted to say that I'm getting back into blogging, and at the same time as this vlog going up, there is also a blog going up which has got, or will have hopefully, loads of pictures from our day as well. So I will link that down in the description, so make sure you go pop over there and show that some love, because I posted the record number of one blog post last year,
because I just lost all of my mojo. But these two girls here are on it with their blogs, and compared to me, you really are.
Yeah.
And I want to get back on it as well. So pop over there and show you that some love as well. But look how cozy we all are.
Cozy.
Your Christmas pajamas.
Christmas PJs.
Did I even show you then? I have no idea.
Yeah, I was
in
it.
We're just watching The Voice as well. But yeah.
Cup of tea.
With a cup of tea. I will soon be making my journey back home.
No!
I'm sorry.
I'm not allowed.
My hour journey back home. Is it weird that I actually quite enjoy those drives though?
Yeah, it's really
I really enjoy like long drives.
Yeah,
yeah. Like put your music on and then going into like your own world.
Just like have a proper sing song.
Yeah. Yes.
Like,
Thank you.
Magic FM is perfect for that.
Is it?
Yeah.
Can we get that in Cambridge, or can you only get that
in
London?
Yeah, I don't know, it's like I was about to say it's worldwide, it's not worldwide. Yeah, you can get it all around with the eco.
Oh,
they're doing the email Magic Love Songs, which is all like proper power ballads.
Yes, that's what I need. Well, we all know what I'm gonna be listening to on the way home now, don't we? Just got home. My cheeks are so red. I got really like hot in the car for some reason. I didn't have the heat up that high. But I am being a proper good best friend right now because Bethany tried to ring me on my way back at like 9:45. Obviously I couldn't answer because I was driving. And I texted her and I got here and I was like, are you okay? Like she has texted me and she tweeted me and everything. I was like, are you okay? And she was like, oh yeah, I just wondered if you could give me a lift into Cambridge. And I was like, give me 10 minutes. I will be there. So I'm going to go take her into Cambridge. I think she's going on a night out, but I might as well do a good friend deed today. So it's 10:30 and then I will come home. I'm debating having some coffee because I need to stay awake and then I can edit the vlog. So hope you appreciate this vlog because it was a late night. And I'm home with a little kiss. I now need to edit the vlog. It is 10:50, so it's definitely going to be a really late night tonight. But I've got my tea and some Terry's chocolate orange to keep me going. I've got my little friendy. Oh, I wasn't impressed with that. So hopefully it will all get done. But I'm going to end it here because it's going to be a long night. I hope you enjoyed the vlog this week. I hope you don't mind a ginger me because I need payday now to sort this out. So I'm going to be ginger for 2 weeks, like a week and a half. Great. So I hope you don't mind a ginger me because you're stuck with it. I also just want to say a massive like welcome to all of my new subscribers over the last few weeks. Thank you so much for clicking that subscribe button. Like, you have no idea what that means to me. Like, maybe you do, but it means a lot and it makes me very happy. Can you take me seriously with this on my face? Because I can't. I keep catching a glimpse of it and I'm just like I got like big best friend points tonight, I can tell you that. Yeah, I don't really know what I'm saying. I'm very delirious, so I'm just gonna go. So give the video a thumbs up, leave me a comment down below, let me know how your week went and what you got up to. Don't forget to subscribe if you are new so you don't miss next week's video. Remember, I have done a blog post as well that will be linked down below. I know, crazy. My last blog post I think was in February last year, so crazy. I'll see you next week. Bye. Bye.